Outside turned off, so we're trying to figure out how to, what happened. We thought a breaker had, you know, tripped or something. Pensamos que se había uno de la mira allá afuera no estaba jalando. So I went to the back and got on the tables and got on the chairs. So there I go, I was climbing up there, you know, thinking I was Superman or Tarzan, Spider-Man, whoever you want to call, some kind of man. I was climbing through there, estaba subiendo, trying to reach the box, and I put my foot on what I thought was something very sturdy, right? The sink is back there, the sink is there. I'm not that heavy. I'm not. I lost a lot of weight. Thank you, Brother Mark. We'll be praying for Brother Mark. Any times that way, we'll pray for him later. But I put my foot on the side of the sink, and it broke, and my foot went all the way down. Man, I said, Lord Jesus. Well, Lord Jesus wasn't the first words that came out. It was just the blood. But so if you see me limping a little bit, it's just my knee. I hit my knee, but I'm okay. I'm good.
Amen.
But it's working. So that's the most important thing. Amen. So I'm glad that you're here today. Estamos contentos que estás aquí. We are going to have the baptism, but I do want to release this word to you. Somebody say, raining favor.
Raining favor.
Say it louder.
Raining favor.
Lloviendo favor. We have been talking about the favor of God. Last week I talked to you about a comeback. Hablé acerca de un regresar. Today I want to talk to you about the favor of God, but just pouring in your life. El favor de Dios que va a ser derramado en tu vida. Raining favor. Say it again. Raining favor. Some of you, like, really, you need to get excited. Because if you don't believe that the favor of God is over your life, then you're not going to receive the favor of God over your life. Amen? Si no crees que el favor de Dios está sobre tu vida, no lo vas a recibir. I am a strong believer that what you confess, you will possess. Yo soy un creyente, mi hermano fiel. Yo creo que lo que tú hablas, tú recibes. If you speak it, you receive it. If you think it, you receive it. Si lo piensas, lo recibes. Because as a man thinks in his heart, so is he. Porque de acuerdo como el hombre piensa en su corazón, así es él. Can I get an amen? So God is about to rain some favor on some people here today. Dios está a punto de llover favor de Dios sobre ciertas personas. Maybe it's not going to be for everybody because everybody's on different levels. And some people do believe, and because of the hell that you may be going through, you don't believe that God is good enough to get you out of the mess. But I'm here to tell you that my God is well able to do exceed and abundantly above all that we can ask or even imagine. The word of God says, amen. La palabra de Dios dice que Dios es más, es fiel y es que puede, Él es más poderoso y es suficiente para sacarnos y darnos más de lo que pensamos o lo que imaginamos. Amén. Así es que I need you to open up your spiritual ears, I need you to open up your heart, and I need you to receive this word. Quiero que reciba esta palabra. Look at you every time. You better receive this word. God made a covenant with Abraham. Dios hizo un pacto con Abraham. And He made a covenant with Abraham, and He started a whole new nation. Dios comenzó toda una nueva nación con Abraham, and God made this covenant with him. And now we, the Bible says that we are the seed of Abraham. Dice la Biblia que nosotros somos la semilla de Abraham. So whatever Abraham, the covenant that was made with Abraham, that covenant lives in us or is for us as well. Esta promesa también es para nosotros. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? And you might say, Pastor, what's the covenant? ¿Cuál es la promesa? It's a good thing you ask. Because we're going to meet it. Okay? Now, can y'all smile? Like, for real, my wife's like, they're not smiling. No están riéndose. No están sonríe, hermano. Sonríe. Amen. A ver, let me see. Starting from this side, smiles. 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 Okay. Good. All right. All right. Just checking. Just checking. Genesis chapter 12, verse 1. Now listen, as we read this, you have to make this yours. You have to make this promise yours. Now listen, let me tell you real quick. I don't care what you are going through right now. Because this word here will override whatever you're going
through. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
I'm going to say that again because I know some of you didn't get it. No importa qué es lo que esté pasando usted, porque esta palabra va a sobrepasar cualquier cosa que usted esté pasando.
Amen.
So I need you to grab a hold of this word. Tell your neighbor, grab a hold of this word. If you don't have a Bible, they're going to put it up here for you. I'm going to read it in English. Lo voy a leer en inglés, por favor. En español me siguen, por favor. It says, "Now the Lord had said to Abram, get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house, to a land that I will show you." He didn't tell him where he's going to take him. He said, "I'm going to show you as you walk through. Te voy a enseñar cuando vayas caminando. Todavía no te digo dónde te voy a llevar nomás a una tierra." Amen. Verse 2, versículo 2. "I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great. And you shall be a blessing." He said, "I'm going to start blessing you, but don't get stuck in the blessing. Te voy a bendecir a ti, pero no te quedes estancado en la bendición." Amen. "I'm going to bless you, but don't get stuck there. No te quedes ahí." Aleluya. Oh, Jesus. "Don't get stuck in just wanting to receive for you, because I have something else for you." Tengo algo más para ti. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Oh, glory, glory. He said, "Listen, I'm going to bless you in a level that you're not going to need a blessing no more. But you are going to be the blessing. Te voy a bendecir a un nivel donde tú ya no vas a necesitar la bendición, sino que tú vas a ser la bendición." He said, "I'm going to bless you that you are no longer going to ask for help or pray for help, but when people pray for help, you're going to show up." He said, "Te voy a bendecir a un nivel," dice Dios, "que cuando la gente ore por ayuda, ya no vas a tú a orar por ayuda, que cuando la gente ore por ayuda, tú vas a venir. Tú vas a ser la ayuda de ellos. When people pray for a miracle, now you're going to be their miracle."
Come on.
Ah, I knew it was going to be a little bit. Because this is gonna do something in our lives, church, because God doesn't want to keep us at one level. God wants to move us from level to level, from glory to glory. De gloria a gloria, de bendición a bendición. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Aleluya. So we need to understand and grab a hold of this word. Entender y recibir esta palabra. This is a good word, by the way. This is a good word. So he said, "I'm going to bless you, and then you shall be a blessing. I'm going to bless you, then you're going to be a blessing. Te voy a bendecir a ti, y luego tú vas a ser una bendición." Verse 3, versículo 3. Listen. "I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse those who curse you. And then all the families of the earth shall be blessed." "Anybody who talks about you after I bless you, I will deal with them."
Come on.
Cualquier gente que hable de ti cuando yo te bendiga, dice el Señor, yo me encargo de ellos. And when you are blessed, if anybody comes and blesses you, then I will bless them. Y cuando estés bendecido, y si alguien viene y te bendice, dice, yo los voy a bendecir. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Amen, somebody. He said, "I'm watching to see what you do when somebody gets blessed." Estoy viendo qué es lo que haces cuando alguien es bendecido. Do you hate on people when they get blessed? No. ¿Odiamos a la gente que son bendecidas?
No.
Because God is watching us to see how we react when somebody gets a new car, or somebody gets a new house, or somebody gets a promotion. God is watching to see how we, not them, how we react towards them. Dios nos está viendo, mi hermano, aleluya. Cuando alguien recibe una promoción, un trabajo nuevo, una casa nueva, un carro nuevo, Dios nos está viendo a ver cómo nosotros reaccionamos a las bendiciones de alguien más. Look at your neighbor and tell him, "It is to your advantage to bless me while I'm blessed." es ventaja tuyo o suya que me bendiga cuando yo soy bendecido. I know you don't want to hear this because we're used to giving to the needy, not to the one that is blessed. Estamos dispuestos a darle al que necesita, no estamos dispuestos a darle al que está bendecido. Come on, somebody. Our mindset is give to the poor. Our mindset is never give to the one who has. It's always give to the one who needs.
Amen.
Tell them it is to your advantage. If you don't have anything good to say, don't say nothing at all. Es para tu ventaja. Si no tienes nada bueno que decir, no digas nada bueno. No digas nada. Amen. Aleluya. It feels tight in here. Say it feels tight. But it's right. Amen. Luke 19, verse 1. I'm going to give you three scriptures real quick. Luke 19, verse 11. I'm sorry, not 1. Verse 11. Luke 19, 11. Glory, glory, glory. Are you excited?
Yes.
Can y'all show it? Glory. Verse 11, 19:11, if you have it. It says, now as they heard these things, he spoke another parable because he was near Jerusalem, and because they thought the kingdom of God would appear immediately. Pensaban que el reino de Dios iba a aparecer inmediatamente. Let me just, before I go any further, let me tell you this. You are already blessed.
Yes. Amen.
Ya eres bendecido. Now, sometimes your blessing doesn't come immediately, but you are already blessed. The thing that you need might not come right now, but you are already blessed. Quizás la cosa no venga inmediatamente, pero ya eres bendecido. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So you are, look at your neighbor, tell them, you are blessed right now. You are blessed right now. Eres bendecido ahorita mismo. Now let's read the story. Vamos a leer la historia. Verse 12, versículo 12. It says, therefore he said, a certain nobleman went into a far country to receive for himself a kingdom and to return. So he called 10 of his servants, delivered to them 10 minas, and said to them, do business till I come. Do business till I come. Hacer negocio hasta que venga. In other words, use what I gave you, put it to work, and I'll come back and check on it. Every one of us in here, cada uno de nosotros aquí, God has given us something. Dios nos ha dado algo. What we do with what God has given us, let me tell you something. He's going to come back and check on that. Dios va a venir a chequear qué es lo que nos dio. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So you better put to work what God gave you. Hay que poner a trabajar lo que Dios nos dio. Amen. Verse 16, versículo 16. Then came the first. He gave to some. Amen. Now verse 16. Then came the first, saying, Master, your mina has earned 10. In other words, he gave 10 to one, and he said, 10. He said, I earned 10 more. And he said to him, well done, good servant, because you were faithful in a very little. You have authority over 10 cities. And then the second came, saying, Master, your mina has earned 5. Likewise, he said to him, you also be over 5 cities. Verse 20. Then the other one came, saying, Master, here is your mina, which I have kept and put away in a handkerchief. For I fear you, because you are an austere men, you collect what you did not deposit and reap what you did not sow. And he said to him, out of your own mouth I will judge you, you wicked servant. You know that I was an austere man, collecting what I do not deposit and reaping what I did not sow. Why then did you not put money in the bank that my coming I might have collected it in interest? Now listen to this. And he said to those who stood by, Take the minus from him and give it to the one who has 10. Take from the one that does not know what to do with it and give it to the one that knows what to do with it. Quítaselo al que no sabe hacer y dáselo al que sí sabe hacer con él. Are you here with me? Oh, glory. In other words, take away from you and give it to the one who produced 100%. Dáselo al que produce 100%. This is good stuff. This is good stuff. Go with me to Zechariah chapter 10, verse 1. Ya creo que vamos. Así que 10 more pages, 10 more pages. Amen. Okay. ¿Están dormidos? No, despierten. Wake up. You have my permission to pinch you. And then we'll pray for them. Amen. Felicitos y luego oramos por ellos. Si se duermen, oramos por ellos. Brother Joel's not here, so we're good. Amen. Zechariah chapter 10, verse 1. Zacarías capítulo 10, versículo 1. Listen to this. Are you ready? Ask the Lord for rain in the time of the latter rain. Ask the Lord for rain in the season of rain. Ask the Lord for rain in the season of rain. Pídele a Dios lluvia en la temporada de la lluvia. This is good, church. Now, he said, I'm going to bless those who bless you. Genesis chapter 12. Voy a bendecir a los que te bendicen. Genesis, that's what we read, correct? He said, I will take from the one who does not know, and I'm going to bless the one who does know. Voy a quitarle al que no sabe, y se lo voy a dar al que sí sabe. Amen? And then he said, pray for rain in the time of rain. Pray for rain when it's already raining. Ora por lluvia cuando ya está lloviendo. He didn't say pray for rain when there's a drought. He said pray for rain when it's raining. Ora por lluvia cuando hay lluvia. Amen. Are you here with me? Hallelujah. So we have been talking about the book of Ruth, and we'll go back to the scriptures here in a minute. We have been talking about the book of Ruth, and I talk to you about what defines a person. Usually, the toughest moments in your life define who you are. Los momentos más difíciles de tu vida definen quién tú eres. I can tell you who you are by how you react to certain things. Te puedo decir quién tú eres por cómo tú, aleluya, sabes manejar la situación que estás pasando. Some of us know how to handle things. Some of us don't know how to. We break down when things are going on in our life. Come on, somebody. So that says a lot about us. Not knowing, Ruth had it all. Ruth lo tenía todo. Amen. But now Ruth is in survival mode. Ahora nomás está sobreviviendo because now she's a beggar. Amen? And we have been talking about Ruth chapter 2. When you go home, read chapter 2. Ruth chapter 2. She is a beggar now. She's begging in a field. And the whole time she's begging, she don't even know that she's blessed. El tiempo que está ella levantando cosecha o mendigando, ella es bendecida. Amen? Why? Because there is a God in heaven. Hay un Dios en el cielo. And he is directing and orchestrating her life. Hay un Dios en el cielo, mi hermano, que está dirigiendo toda su vida, todos los pasos. So let me tell you something. You can't see God physically, but I want to tell you today, he's working on your behalf right now as we speak.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Help me out here. God is working on your behalf, and I want to tell you today that there is a comeback. Get ready for the camp comeback that you're doing. Vas a hacer un avance, aleluya. Tú vas a regresar otra vez. ¿Cuánto dicen amén? Why? Because God already started preparing everything. Dios empezó a preparar todo lo que tiene que preparar. God is using a tool called favor. Dios está usando una herramienta que se llama favor, aleluya. The favor of God, the favor of God. The favor of God is something God does not in you, but he does in a person, amen, from which you need the favor from.
Come on,
somebody. El favor de Dios no es para ti. El favor de Dios no está en ti. El favor de Dios está en la persona que tú necesitas el favor con ella. So we get frustrated because God is not talking to us. We get frustrated because we don't hear from God. Estamos frustrados porque Dios no nos habla. Estamos frustrados porque Dios no nos ha dicho nada. But I want to tell you something, that when Israel began to cry unto God, cuando Israel empezó a clamar a Dios, cuando Israel empezó a llorarle a Dios, let me tell you something, God didn't talk to Israel. Dios no le habló a Israel. You know what God did? God turned a bush in fire and he called the man and said, Moses, I want you to come here.
Yes.
¿Verdad? Moisés, ven. Estaba quemándose la zarza, dijo Dios. Moisés, ven. Now listen, listen. Listen to God's word. Mira la palabra de Dios. God said, I heard my people and I heard their cry. Dios dijo, escuché a mi pueblo y el clamor de mi pueblo Israel. Now, that's it. He didn't say, I went to go speak to Israel. He said, I heard them cry. So he said, I need you to go.
That's right.
Oh, my goodness. I'm about to slap myself here. It is possible, but listen. I'm not going to slap myself with my glasses. I'm fine. I need my glasses. But listen. God never spoke to Israel. God spoke to Israel's help. Dios nunca le habló a Israel. Dios le habló a la ayuda de Israel. You know why God ain't talking to you? Because he's talking to your help.
Wow.
La razón que Dios no te está hablando a ti es porque Dios le está hablando a tu ayuda. You're praying for favor. God said, okay, I'm working on it. Don't get frustrated if I don't talk to you. Don't get frustrated if I don't tell you anything. Because I'm talking to your help. Estoy hablando a la ayuda. Are you here with me? So whatever it is that you're praying for, hallelujah, just give God praise because your help is on the way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, it may take a little bit longer because sometimes our help is a little bit stubborn.
Come on.
A veces la ayuda está un poquita cabezuda. So Moses said, God said, Moses, I need you to go to deliver my people. He's like, then he's having a conversation with God. God, I don't know how to talk. Well, how are you talking to me? Well, I'm stuttering because I'll take care of that.
Yes.
Not knowing that all along when Moses was going to go help Israel, he was being blessed himself.
Right.
Sin saber Moisés que al momento que él iba a ayudar a Israel, Dios también lo iba a bendecir a él. Are you here with me today?
Yes.
Look at your neighbor today and say, your help is on the way. God is speaking to your help. Dios está ayudándole a tu ayuda. Y ahí viene. Toma sobre el pelo. He's coming. He's coming. He's coming. Your help. I don't know who it is. I don't know what it is. Oh, God, send me a man. Hallelujah. Listen, if you're single, all my single ladies, let me tell you, I want to sing to you that song because I don't know that song and I don't know how to sing. But listen, single ladies, if you're praying for a prince, don't get set up for the frog, because the frog is not going to change into a prince. Hallelujah. Come on. If you're praying for a boy, don't get set up for Bozo, because Bozo is not coming. Bozo don't look like Boaz. Bozo looks like a Bozo. Come on, somebody. You want a prince, you go to the castle. You don't go to the bar and pick up a prince at the bar. Come on, somebody. If you need a good man, you need to go with a good man. Oh, where can I find a good man? Where can I find a good one? You're going to looking for love.
Come on, somebody.
Y'all know all those songs. Buscando amor en diferentes lugares y no lo encuentras. You're looking in all the wrong places. And you, can I tell you something? Sometimes you settle. You settle for anything because of what people have told you. Te conformas con lo que you never want to be. You're never going to be a good guy, so you settle for whatever comes. Woo! Jesus. Man, oh man, oh man, oh man. Look at your neighbor and tell him, God is starting to move. No, God is starting to move. Listen. God has to kick the old to bring the new. You can't serve two masters. And you can't have two Johnnies. One John, you gotta go. No podemos servir a dos señores. Y no podemos tener a dos Juanes. Un Juan se tiene que ir. ¿Cómo? You gotta throw that little black book out the way. You gotta delete some numbers and you gotta delete some messages and you gotta delete some people from your phone. Those backup ones. Come on, somebody. Just in case this one don't work, I still got Johnny faithful over here. Johnny, I can call Johnny at any time and Johnny will pick up the phone. Come on, somebody. You need to listen. God has the person for you. Dios tiene la persona para ti. Are you here with me? Come on, somebody. Because you never tell me if you ask for help, then wait for it. God don't need your help. God does not need your help. God does not need your help. Dios no necesita tu ayuda. Glory. Hallelujah. My God, hallelujah. I didn't know if I was going to go that way or not. But praise the Lord. I mean, that's free. That's free right there. I mean, I ain't charging for nothing right there. Amen. So look at everything. God is starting the process. The first stage of favor. Catch this. The first stage of favor is blessing you. El primer paso, la primera etapa del favor es cuando Dios te bendice. The first step of favor is when Ruth just happens to work in the same field that belongs to Boaz. La primera etapa de la bendición o del favor de Dios, hermano, es cuando dice la palabra de Dios que Ruth sucedió trabajar en el mismo campo que era de Boaz. Are you? She is in survival mode. And listen, as we are reading Ruth's story, because it's already been written and finished. Right? Estamos leyendo la vida de Ruth, hermano, y la estamos viendo nosotros desde el principio al final porque alguien la escribió y ya está escrita. It's already done. Now, Ruth does not know how it's going to end. At this moment, she's still going through the story. She doesn't know what's on the other side. Are you here with me? Now, you are going through your story. You don't know how your story is going to end. Nosotros ahorita estamos pasando por nuestra historia. Y no sabemos cómo va a terminar. But there is a God in heaven. I said there is a God in heaven. Hay un Dios en el cielo. And he already started your life and he already completed your life. La comenzó y la terminó. Now he's just watching you go through your life. Estás pasando por tu vida. Are you here with me? Ruth doesn't know that she's going to meet Boaz, but we know that because we read the story. I feel like running. If it wasn't for this knee, I would be running right now. You don't know who you're going to meet tomorrow. You don't know where the blessing is coming from tomorrow. But right now you're going through your story. Ahorita vas caminando por tu historia, por la etapa de tu vida y no sabes quién te va a bendecir mañana. No sabes a quién vas a conocer mañana. But God is up there saying, don't give up this day. Don't give up this day. You're going to meet him tomorrow. You're going to meet the blessings coming tomorrow. La bendición viene mañana. No te lo he prometido. It's right there. You get this close. Hallelujah. And Ruth is going through the process. Ruth está pasando por el proceso. Are you here with me?
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah. If you never tell her, she's blessed. She's blessed. Oh, glory, glory, glory. So God is moving. God is moving. So now, catch this. She's going and she's picking up the leftovers. Está levantando las sombras. Then Boaz comes and says, listen, he tells the workers, listen, drop a little bit more on purpose.
Yes. Come on.
There's some on purpose kind of blessing coming for somebody today.
Yes.
Hay bendiciones a propósito. Boaz le dijo, dejen un poquito más a propósito. She don't know. At first, she's just gathering a little bit. She went from not having enough to just enough. No, 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 no quiere lo mismo. To just enough. Ella movió de no tener lo suficiente a solamente tener suficiente. So she's gathering, and then all of a sudden she starts seeing a little bit more. She's like, they're dropping more. Están dejando caer más. Woo, Jesus. Mike, are you here with me today?
Amen.
The first stage is called just enough. Look at you, everything. I'm just enough. She moved from not enough to just enough. Se movió de no tener suficiente hasta tener lo más suficiente. So she's going through her life. And listen, it's just enough for the day. Es no más, nada más es suficiente, mi hermano, para el día. She can't store up for tomorrow because it's not enough. It's just sufficient for that day. Solamente es suficiente para ese día. No es. You can't get rich of just enough. No puedes hacerte rico, mi hermano, con solamente es suficiente.
That's right.
You can't have an overflow with just enough. No puedes tener una abundancia, mi hermano, con solamente es suficiente. Are you here with me? So God is about to move you. God is starting the process. Dios comenzó el proceso. And God is moving you. And he's telling you, listen, don't get satisfied with just enough. No te quedes satisfecho con solamente es suficiente.
Amen.
Just enough is not enough.
That's right. Come on.
You didn't hear me. Just enough. And look at you and tell him, just enough is not enough. Hallelujah. Solamente es suficiente no es suficiente. There is some just enough, hallelujah, people right now that are living their life right now. But God said, I'm going to bless you. Yo te voy a bendecir. Abraham, I'm going to bless you. Te voy a bendecir, Abraham. I'm going to listen. First thing God said, he says, listen, I'm going to work on you first before I work on anybody else. Right? He said, listen, Abraham, I'm going to bless you. I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to deal with your family. I'm going to do this for you. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Right now, it's just Abraham about you. Abraham, ahorita solamente es de ti. Te voy a bendecir a ti. Te voy a bendecir a tu familia. I'm going to bless your children. I'm going to give you energy. I'm going to give you joy. I'm going to give you peace. Te voy a dar paz. Te voy a dar energía. Te voy a dar la fuerza. I'm going to pull you out of this mess that you're in. Te voy a sacar de este mugrero en la cual te has metido. I'm going to give you the ability to sleep. Vas a poder dormir en la noche. Anybody can sleep. If you can't sleep at night, just wave your hand, hallelujah. And I want to tell you that you're going to start sleeping at night, hallelujah. God said, I'm going to make you stop fighting, hallelujah. Ya no va a haber contienda. There's not going to be no more strife in your house. I'm going to take care of your kids. I'm going to straighten out your kids. Voy a componer a tus hijos, hallelujah. If they're messing up, listen, you're not going to be starving no more. I'm going to get you to a place. I want to work on you. He said, you're blessed because you're not in the pit no more. And you're not in the mud. But you're out of the pit and you're out of the mud. Has salido del lodo. Has salido del pozo. Ahora estás afuera. Now you are outside and you just have enough. There's a lot of people who said it was just enough. Are you here with me? But there's levels of blessing. There's levels of ministry. Hay niveles del ministerio. Listen, when I had 5 people or 10 people, when we started our church, we had about 7 to 10 people. And we would do ministry different than what we do today. Hacíamos el ministerio diferente. So as the church started growing, la iglesia crecía, we had to do certain things a little bit different. Right? Because 10 people, real quick, aquí lo meto los 10, I just put 10 people right here. But when you have 30 or 40 or 50, man, where am I going to put them? So you have to do things different. You have to give people to help you. Tienes que tener gente que te ayude. Are you here with me? There's levels of blessing. There's levels of faith. Hay niveles de la fe. There's some people that are here for the first time, and you are at the first stage of faith. There's people that have been here for a year, 2 years, 3 years, and their faith level is a little bit higher than others. El nivel de fe es más alto que alguno de otros. So there's levels of faith. You can't just stay in one level. No podemos quedarnos en un nivel. Debe haber muchos niveles. Are you here with me? And there's also levels of blessing. There's levels of favor. Hay niveles de favor y hay niveles de bendición. Look at your neighbor and tell them, there's levels of blessing. There's levels of blessing. And I'm going to give you, I'm going to show you how. I need 3 people. Real quick. 3. Come on. 3 people. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. Three generations. That's the fourth right there. All right. So y'all gonna be in line right here. Y'all gonna face that way. Ricky, demonstración. Le voy a hacer una demostración para que entiendan. So you can see. You need to see what I am trying to tell you. We can't have haters in the church. We can't have haters in the church. Hermano, no debe de haber gente en la iglesia que odia. We have to learn to celebrate. Where's all my amens? Anybody? We have to learn to celebrate. Debemos de celebrar. Okay. Levels of faith. Levels of blessing. Niveles de bendición. Let's say Sarah is a homeless person. She's not, we're just saying as an example, as an ejemplo, okay? Ella es una persona, ¿verdad?, que anda mendigando las calles. Vamos a decirlo así. She doesn't have a place to stay. She doesn't have no food. No tiene comida, no tiene lugar donde quedarse. Sarah, last night, they took her to a homeless shelter. La llevaron a albergue, ¿verdad?, de la gente que se queda. So they took her to a shelter, homeless shelter. She got a warm meal this morning, and they invited her to church. Recibió una comida calentita, y la invitaron a la iglesia. So when church started, Sarah is up here praising God like crazy. Está orando a Dios como loca aquí. Why? Because she got a place to sleep. And she got a warm meal. Where is it going? Yes. So she's blessed. In her mind, in her mind, she's like, I'm blessed. I got a place to sleep last night. I got me a warm meal, so I'm blessed. One level of blessing. Right here. Now let's say that Sister Pita just bought her first house. Acaba de comprar su propia casa. She is the first person in her family to ever own a house. La primera persona en su familia que es dueña de una casa. Same church. Están en el mismo servicio. And she's up here praising God because she's the first person that ever owned her own place. And she's grateful to God because now she's able to, she's blessed. She's another level of blessing. Amen. Es otro nivel de bendición. Are you seeing? One level with the homeless, one level with the owner of a house. Un nivel del ¿cómo se dice? El que anda mendigando. I don't know what the name is. ¿Cuántos saben que es el nombre ese? Homeless. Okay, one. Y ella acaba de comprar una casa. Different levels. Now, Gia just bought a whole apartment complex that was worth $3 million. $3 millones de dólares. Un apartamento, un duplex de apartamento grande. Ella lo acaba de comprar. Now, she's celebrating it because this is the first time she has ever bought something that big. Ella está celebrando, she's praising God, ella está adorando a Dios, porque ella es la primera en su familia de comprar algo así grande. So different levels, catch this, she has to celebrate her, ella tiene que celebrarla a ella, she has to celebrate her. Ella tiene que celebrar a ella. She has to celebrate her. And they got to celebrate each other. Why? Because they're on different levels. They're not all on the same level. They're on different levels. But it's the same blessing. Es la misma bendición, pero diferentes niveles. She's just happy that she got a meal. And she's praising God with everything that she has. So we celebrate God because she got a meal. Celebramos a Dios porque ella recibió un alimento. But we also celebrate her because she just got her first house.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
This is you. This is you. You have to celebrate. Our thing is that we don't celebrate people. We hate on them. No celebramos a la gente. Nosotros la odiamos. I think you're doing drugs. I think this girl here is selling drugs. That's why she got a new house.
Come on.
Yeah. She must be selling. A lo mejor ella está vendiendo droga porque tiene casa nueva. O a lo mejor ella está vendiendo. Maybe there's something going down. Amen. Under the table, she might be doing something wrong. That's our mindset. Esa es nuestra mentalidad. And we have not because we don't celebrate. No tenemos porque no celebramos. Listen, if you want to get blessed, celebrate them in their time of blessing. Celébralos en el tiempo de bendición. Listen, I might not be at this level, I might not be here yet, and I might not be here yet, but I have to do something to get here, so I have to celebrate you while I'm here.
Come on, Jesus, thank you, Lord.
Ruth was faithful in somebody else's field. And if you can't celebrate and work in somebody else's field, you'll never get your field.
Come on.
If you can't celebrate her house, you'll never get your house. If you can't never celebrate her condo, you'll never get a condo yourself. Pastor, I don't need a condo. I'm just happy where you are. Well, you're going to stay there for years, but I don't know. I want to move from level to level, from glory to glory, forever and ever and ever. So you have to celebrate the people. Ruth was faithful. Who's that girl? She said, this girl, from morning to dawn, she's been working. She hasn't stopped. She's been faithful. Not knowing that the field that she worked was going to be hers. I want to tell you, those of you, where you are, there's some things that are supposed to be yours, but you're not faithful. You're not faithful with what God has entrusted you. No eres fiel con lo que Dios te ha confiado. So you can't have, and you can cry all you want. God is not moved by tears. Hold on, let me say that again. Because I know I just messed some people up. God is not moved by tears. God is moved by obedience. You want God to move? Then obey. Queremos que Dios se mueva? Vamos a obedecer a Dios. You can cry all you want, but until you obey God, God will move on your behalf. You'll say, well, then come on, come on, somebody. So you need to celebrate them while they have, so that way you can do and have what they have. Pastor, well, I'm not a woman. That's okay. But celebrate her. Because she got a meal. And she's happy. Now, she may not know where her next meal is, but if God saw her happy when she got one meal, imagine what God's going to do to her and going to keep on blessing her because she came to thank God. Listen, you know what? We don't thank God for the most insignificant things. No le damos gracias a Dios por las cosas más insignificantes. So how many of us, and listen, don't raise your hands, please. How many of us run out of our house without first thanking Him for waking us up? ¿Cuántos de nosotros nos salimos de la casa corriendo porque maybe you're late to work, you overslept, you're late, so you forgot to pray and you take off to work? Well, God knows my heart. Of course He does. But God also knows that you stayed up last night when you shouldn't have stayed up last night. You should have gone to bed.
Come on.
Turn off the TV, turn off the phone, go to bed, because tomorrow's another day. Come on, somebody.
Yes.
It is quiet today. Right? So we don't thank God. We don't thank Him for the most insignificant. You know when we thank God? And we know when we come to God? When the rope is up right here. And you can't breathe. Cuando la soga está, nos está ahorcando, después nos acordamos de Dios. Why not thank Him while I have? Don't just thank God or praise God when all is going good. Praise God when all is going bad. No solamente adores a Dios cuando todo va bien. Adora a Dios cuando todo va mal. Praise Him when you're going through the valley. Adora a Dios cuando vas por el valle. Praise God when you're going through the hills. Cuando vas por las montañas, adora a Dios. Come on, somebody. Learn to thank God for the little things. Because listen, sooner or later, she'll have her house. Because God sees her reaction. Dios mira la reacción, not in the big things, but in the small things. Because He said, if you're faithful in the little, I'm going to put you in bigger things.
Yes, amen.
A lot of us, we don't celebrate that person that got a promotion in our job because you wanted that promotion. Now you're talking about it. And God said, well, I know I'm going to put you up there. Because if that's the attitude you have before you get that job, I wonder how you're going to act when you get that job.
You're right.
Nobody say nothing. Nothing. God wants to bless us. God said, listen, take from the one who doesn't have and give to the one who has. Why am I going to bless her? She's got already 100%. He said, and she knows what to do. She don't know what to do with it. But she knows what to do with it. We have to learn how to bless those who are blessed. Not only bless those who are in need. How many want the reign of God? ¿Cuántos quieren la lluvia del Señor? If you want the reign of God, then you have to do what God is telling us. How many of you got prayer for me? Pray for rain in the time of rain. Ora por lluvia en el tiempo de la lluvia. Are you here with me today? Say amen, somebody. So this is not much a sermon, but it is a prophetic word to you today. That God already started the process. But he's watching you to see how you respond. How you respond to somebody else's blessing. ¿Cómo tú vas a responder a la bendición de alguien más? Are you? Oh, glory. The first dimension of blessing, listen. The first dimension of blessing is what? God wants to take care of you. This is what he told Abraham. He said, I'm going to bless you. Then, the second one is this. You are going to be a blessing. When God blesses you, church, it's not for you. When God blesses you, it's for somebody else. But you will always have. Because you are a channel which God just begins to pour. The first level is, I want to take care of you. The second level is, I'm going to work through you. El primer nivel dice, Dios te voy a bendecir a ti. El segundo nivel dice, voy a bendecir a ti. Now, Ruth is no longer behind the reapers. Now, she's side by side with the reapers. Now she doesn't have to pick up leftovers. Now she's got her own harvest that she has to pick. Ahora ella tiene su cosecha que va a levantar. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Look at your neighbor and tell them, God has favor on you. God is shifting something in your life. Dios está a punto de cambiar algo en tu vida. God is about to shift. God is about to send the rain. Dios está a punto de mandar la lluvia, aleluya, sobre tu vida. And all you got to do is be faithful to God. Fiel a Dios. Amen. I believe that there is something that is coming to you.
Yes.
I believe that there is a blessing. I believe that there is a turnaround coming in your life.
Come on. Receive it. Thank you, Jesus.
I don't care where you are. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care what situation you're facing. There's a blessing with your name on it. And if you're faithful to God with the small things that he's given you, God is going to bless you in something else. Amen. Anybody blessing from the Lord? Anybody need God's favor on your life or somebody? Who needs help today? ¿Cuánto necesitan ayuda? If you need help, God said, I'm working on it. Give it time. Your help is on the way. Your help is on the way. But don't give up. And don't give up. Ruth lost it all. She lost her husband. She lost it all. She lost it all. But then God brought her back. He said, I'm going to bless you. The way I am. Are you here? Why don't you stand to your feet today? God is good. Say, God is good.
God is good.
God is good. God is good. Come on, somebody. Those of you who are going to get baptized.